Hey guys, is India bringing back ancient technology? In my channel, I've shown you a lot of ancient temples and how they were made entirely out of granite and how these granite blocks were assembled at a grand scale. But will someone build a house today completely made out of granite? Well, someone has done it. Someone has brought back this ancient technology and has built an entire house made of granite. Let's go inside and take a look. At first look, we can see that it looks quite modern with solar power system at the top and even has its own power line. As you can see, this is the main entrance and inside you can see a lot of really amazing things. But I'm going to sneak through the side and see what's here. This is really amazing because you can see the walls, the ceiling, and the columns are all made of solid granite. Let's take this column, for example, and you can see that the base is made of one granite block. The shaft, the entire shaft, is made of one granite block. And the top part, or the capital, is made of one granite block. And it must definitely remind you of ancient temples, because you can see the design here. The capital is definitely based on the design of ancient temples. I've shown you the same design in several ancient temples. Let's enter this house and see what's inside. Wow. As you can see, it's equipped with modern technology. Oh, there is a Buddha here. You can see it looks quite blissful. But in ancient temples, they've used some magic. They did not use any binding agents at all. To combine two stone blocks, they did not use glue or any binding agent. For example, in the great Brihadeeswara temple in Tanjore, no binding agent or glue has been used in the entire temple. All the giant granite blocks were interlocked using the tongue and groove method, making the entire temple into a giant Lego block structure. Believe it or not, in this modern house, they did not use any binding agents. Following the ancient technology, they have not used any glue or binding agent to bind the stone blocks. They've used the ancient technology, the tongue and groove method. They've also put together these stone blocks using the tongue and groove locking system. I call it the female male locking system. And you can see how they've assembled the entire structure. This column, this ceiling, these beams, they're all assembled together using this interlocking technology, using no glue or any binding agent. But how did they assemble the entire structure just using interlocking system and adding no binding agents? Now, let me show you something very interesting right here. So you can see this is a column, this is the capital of the column, and this is the beam running horizontally on both sides. But here, you see this? Your immediate reaction would be to think that, oh, this is a binding agent used to bind the beam and the column. But no, these beams and the column are interlocked using the tongue and groove method. But what is this? This is grout. Now, what is this used for? To prevent water seeping through the cracks. You see, no matter how hard we try to assemble the blocks together, there will be some micron level differences between them. And water will seep through those micron level cracks. To prevent that, they add this grout to prevent water seepage. So you can see this grout in all these places. But this grout material is not put in as a binding agent. It's put in to make sure the water doesn't seep through these micron level cracks. And there's one more aspect to it, to make it look good for good aesthetics. It makes it look good because the cracks won't be visible. But something is quite intriguing, right? I mean, you can see this is a modern house with all the advanced equipment and furnishing. But where are all the wires? Where are all the cables and where are all the pipes? You won't see anything. Why? Because they are hidden inside these granite beams and walls. You won't find them unless you really look for them. Can you see? It's right here. It's very interesting because 99% of the people are not going to notice the detail. You can see a circle here. This is a pipe either for water or for electricity or some other wiring. And if you start looking for these hidden details, you will find them everywhere. And you will see no wires at all because everything has been perfectly planned, just like the ancient Kailasa temple. But how long will a modern house last? 50 years? 100 years? But how long will this house last? This house could last for thousands of years. And this is exactly why I'm examining this structure. Think about it. What would be the age of this temple? It could potentially last forever. Why do modern houses deteriorate within 100 years? Because they are made of bricks, concrete, and other disintegrating materials. But what about this house? Since this house is made of giant granite blocks and interlocking stone technology, this house could last for thousands of years, just like ancient Indian temples. Imagine buying a house that your future generations will live in that same house for thousands of years. That's pretty unique. Imagine the stone chariot of Hampi. Would it still be standing if it were made of bricks? No, it still stands there even after centuries of rain and shine and even human destruction, unfazed. If you just look next to the stone chariot of Hampi, you can see this brick tower and see what has happened to it. It is destroyed because it was made with bricks. So this structure is going to last for thousands of years. But there is a huge advantage hidden in this building. Guess what? It is the air conditioning. No, I'm not talking about these air conditioners. Of course, this house is fully equipped with all these artificial air conditioners. But granite structures have their own natural air conditioning. They regulate temperature naturally. Now, let's say you enter into an ancient temple made of granite and it's a hot, sweaty day. You'll be surprised as soon as you enter the temple. Why? Because immediately you're going to realize that the temple is cool and it immediately cools the temperature down. And let's say you enter the temple, probably even the same temple, on a cold evening. You immediately realize that even though it's cold outside, it's warm and cozy inside the temple. Why? Because ancient builders
were very scientific, and they knew that granite has a very high thermal mass. Now, what is thermal mass? Thermal mass is the ability of a material to absorb the heat, store it, and release it accordingly. Granite has a very high thermal mass. So this house, if you enter this house during a hot summer day, it's going to be cool inside. And if you actually come inside this house during winters, it's going to be warm and cozy because it provides natural temperature regulation. But imagine a temple that's entirely made out of wood. This would be really odd because wood has very low thermal mass. It does not actually absorb the heat and release it properly. So if you enter into a temple that's made entirely out of wood, it would be hot in the summer inside the temple. And if you walk into it during winter time, it will be cold inside the temple as well. Speaking of wood, I have a theory. In ancient times, there were lots of temples made out of wood, and people burnt them down in the past. And we don't even know that these wooden temples existed because there is no trace of them. Why? Because wood can easily burn, but granite is fire resistant. And this is why ancient megalithic temples survived, because nothing can happen to granite, even if people set it on fire. And forget people setting them on fire. Even in wildfires, like the wildfire happening in California, you can see a lot of destruction happening in the US because most of the houses are made with disintegrating material. But this granite house will not be touched by any kind of fire. So remember, even though this house is equipped with all the modern amenities, even has a jacuzzi and a gym, the core structure is made mimicking ancient technology. This house is a giant Lego block structure made with giant granite stone blocks using interlocking stone technology. And I personally think this house can withstand even 100 earthquakes. So you can see how India is slowly bringing back its ancient technology. Imagine a country full of modern houses made out of solid granite that will last for thousands of years. This is not only the past of India, but this is also going to be the future of India. Using ancient technology and building eco-friendly houses that will last forever. I hope you like this video. I am Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll talk to you soon.